Welcome to my third lesson on trigonometry. Last time, we met the most famous trig identity. Sine squared plus cosine squared equals 1. If you're following my math tutorials, you might have noticed that I purposely fit in a Calc 2 topic, even though you might not understand it, to show you that this identity is used extensively later on. In this lesson, we'll derive some other trig identities that are used in a similar fashion in Calc 2. First, let's review the definitions of tangent, cotangent, secant, and cosecant. This is from lesson 1. Tangent is defined to be sine over cosine. Cotangent is 1 over tangent, and that's the same as cosine over sine. Secant is 1 over cosine, and cosecant is 1 over sine. Ready? Here are the two identities that we're going to derive. There's good news, we don't have to memorize these because they are so easy to derive. Later on though, we use these two so much that most of us end up memorizing them anyway. Where do they come from? From our favorite trig identity. Now, how are we going to introduce a tangent into the equation? Chipmunk? Where's Chipmunk? Uh-oh, Chipmunk's absent today. We'll have to figure it out ourselves. Let's see, how do we get tangent in there? Tangent is sine over cosine. Can we write cosine on the bottom somehow? Yep, all we have to do is divide each term by cosine squared. We get sine squared over cosine squared plus cosine squared over cosine squared equals 1 over cosine squared. Now I'm not saying the theta, but make sure you write it in, okay? Sine squared over cosine squared is tan squared. The next term, everything cancels, we get a 1. And the 1 over cosine squared is secant squared. There it is. The identities on top are just rearrangements of this equation. Secant squared is 1 plus tan squared, and tan squared is secant squared minus 1. Those formats are the ones we end up using later. Next, we'll look at two identities related to cotangent and cosecant. We rarely use these, definitely not enough to memorize them. So make sure you remember how to derive them and you'll be all set. Same idea, we start with our favorite trig identity. And this time we want to introduce cotangent into the equation. Remember, cotangent is cosine over sine. All we have to do is divide each term by sine squared. Let's do it. We get sine squared over sine squared plus cosine squared over sine squared equals 1 over sine squared. The first term is 1. The second term is cotangent squared. And on the right side, we have cosecant squared. Rearranging the terms give us the identities on top. All done. Okay, I hope you enjoyed these easy proofs. Next time, we'll check out a few other useful trig identities. See you then. Bye.